Assalamu alaikum, my dear students. How are you? Hope all of you are well by the grace of Almighty Allah. Welcome to NIEBS Home School. This is Shahzade Akhtar, Assistant Teacher of Science of National Ideal English Vocational School, Day Shift. Today, I am going to take a science class for class 7 students. My dear students, our today's topic, chapter 8 discussion, our today's lecture number 10 and SW number 6. My dear students, let's start our class. This is chapter 8 about sound. The chapter name is about sound. My dear students, we know that we hear many kinds of sound. Sound plays an important role in our life and it helps us to communicate with others. We hear different types of sound around us, and we know that sound is one kind of energy which helps us to hear. My dear students, now we will discuss about sound and its characteristics. We know that sound are of two kinds of sounds, tuneful sound and tuneless sound. Tuneful and tuneless sound, whatever it may be, all sounds have a source. Sound is produced from any source. We can understand the source of sound from its characteristics, such as by hearing the sound of barking, we can understand that the dog is barking. Okay, now the origin of sound. Sound is a kind of energy that produces the feeling of hearing. Now we will do some words from which we can understand that how sound is produced. Okay, now go to next page. We have to sound is produced. We have already known that sound is produced through the vibration of the object, and vibrating object which produce sound is called source of sound. Now, circulation of sound or propagation of sound. My dear students, we know that vibrating objects make sound. How does the sound reach to the listeners? Okay, let us consider an example. Any vibrating wire of a musical instrument or any vibrating arm of a tuning fork vibrates the molecules of air around them. The vibration passes to transfers to next molecules of the air. The vibration passes or transfers to the next molecule of the air, and the sound reaches to the listeners by turns from a source like wave. And the movement created by the vibrating particles of any medium which is circulated through a medium is called wave. My dear students, so from this lesson we have learned that what is wave. Okay, the movement created by the vibrating particles of any medium which is circulated through a medium is called wave. And now give example. Suppose take a long spring and strike it one end, and you will find as a result of its construction and expansion it circulates energy. My dear students, see the figure. This is the example of circulation of sound and propagation of sound. Here given the long spring and strike it one end, and then we can find its construction and expansion, and in the and by this construction and expansion it circulates the energy. The wave of sound circulates in the same way. The movement of sound from one place to another called circulation of sound. And circulation of sound needs a medium. My dear students, circulation of sound needs a medium. The medium may be solid, liquid or gaseous. Sound circulates very first through solid medium, then liquid medium, and then the gaseous medium. My dear students, this is the important MCQ. Sound may be circulated by very first solid medium, then liquid medium, and then the gaseous medium. Okay, now come to next lesson, propagation of sound through liquid and velocity of sound. We have already learned that the circulation of sound needs a medium, and sound cannot be circulated without medium. Sound circulates very first through solid, then liquid, then gaseous medium. Now come to next lesson, circulation of sound through solid and its velocity of sound. Sound circulation is first is more than clear than sodium solid medium, than the air and the liquid medium. Okay, my dear students, then the velocity of sound varies with the variation of solid substances. Okay, the velocity of sound in the air is 343 meter per second. My dear students, you have to learn properly this one. the velocity of sound in air is 343 meter per second. The velocity of sound in the water 1496 meter per second, and the velocity of sound in aluminium is 6420 meter per second. My dear students, you have to learn for this for MCQ and mathematical problem also. So the velocity of sound differs from medium to medium, and sound can be circulated fast and more clearly through solid substances than the medium of liquid or air. On the other hand, sound can be circulated faster and more clearly through liquid than the medium of air. Okay, now come to next topic. How can animals hear sound? My dear students, we know the vibrating objects produce sound, and that sound is circulated all the directions through medium. Now the question is, how can we hear sound? The outer shape of our ear looks mostly like a funnel. When a sound enters into it, that means the outer layer of the our ear, sound goes through a hole where there is a stretched thin layer at the end, and this layer is called tympanum. This layer plays an important role. The role is that the vibration of sound vibrates the tympanum, and vibration reaches inside the ear through this, and sound reaches to the brain from here. Thus the ear can hear the sound, and we will do the test to know the importance of this tympanum. My dear students, now come to next topic. This is important topic, limit of audibility and noise. My dear students, we have already learned that sound is produced as a result of vibration of an object. Now, we cannot hear the sound of all vibrating objects. Man cannot hear the sound which creates 20 vibrations per second. My dear students, underline this flag. Man cannot hear the sound which creates 20 vibrations per second. Such sound is not audible. Such sound is called inaudible sound. My dear students, so from this lesson we have learned that what is inaudible sound. And on the other hand, we cannot hear the sound which produces more vibration. We cannot hear the sound which produces more than 20,000 vibration per second. So such sound is also inaudible. So such sound is called ultrasound. My dear students, so we have already learned here the what is ultrasound. So ultrasound means the that type of sound that which are produced more than 20,000 vibrations per second. This sound is called inaudible sound or ultrasound. And so the limit of the audibility of for man is created sound ranging from 20 to 20,000 vibrations. My dear students, this is important MCQ. And the audibility, the number of vibrations per second of an object is called frequency. My dear students, you have to memorize properly this definition also. What is frequency? The number of vibrations per second of an object is called frequency. It is denoted by the unit of hertz. So my dear students, the unit of frequency is hertz. When any object vibrates 20 per second, its vibration is 20 hertz, and if it vibrates 20,000 per second, then this vibration is 20,000 hertz. So the limit of audibility of man is from 20 to 20,000 hertz. So my dear students, from this topic, above this topic, we have learned that the limit of audibility of man is 20 to 20,000 hertz. Such limit of vibration of sound is called audible sound. Now, some animals can hear the sounds which has more than 20,000 hertz. The dog has this ability. Police uses high frequency whistles which the dog can hear but man cannot. So in medical science, we are also familiar with the excess sound creating machine, and one of them is the ultrasonogram. And this machine works with more than 20,000 hertz for frequency. My dear students, now we will discuss about well audible sound and noise. My dear students, the well audible sound means we can hear different sounds all around us. Out of them, some sounds are pleasing to ear and comfortable. Such sounds are tune of song, tune of flute, tune of the sound of harmonium and play, or on sitar, etc. So such sound is called well audible sound. And many sounds are unpleasant, harsh and disturbing to the ear. And such sounds are the sound of pushing nail, sound of construction, the sound of chalk while you write on the board, the uniform of vibration of an object produce well audible sound. And now, what is noise? The sound which is unpleasant to ear, the comfortable and disturbing is called noise. So, my dear students, from this topic, we have learned what is well audible sound and what is noise. Now, sound pollution. We all are acquainted with pollution of air and water. We call pollution of water when it contains foreign particles in our environment. If there is excess or unexpected sound, then we will call it pollution of sound. The main cause of pollution of sound are horn of vehicles, explosion, sound of machines, sound of mics and sound of construction works. Besides watching TV or listening to radio with excessive sounds, the sound from kitchen, sound of air cooler, etc. are the causes of sound pollution. My dear students, now we will discuss about what harms does sound pollution causes. We know that the problems of insomnia, headache, high blood pressure, disturbance, depression and many other problems. If a man hears a loud sound, it may because hard of hearing, even he or she can be deaf. Okay, now how can we will discuss about how can we prevent sound pollution. Okay, we can prevent sound pollution by this way. We should keep out all the things which create noise. We will not establish any factory in residential area which creates noise. Less use of horns of vehicles. We should not use radio, TV and other musical instrument with loud voice. We have to plant trees around the houses by the side of the or by the side of the road so that they can prevent sound. My dear students, go to next topic, sound making machines. Sound making machines are of two kinds, my dear students. This one is MCQ, musical instruments and non-musical instruments. Musical instruments are flute, harmonium, one string and two strings instrument and sitar, etc. And our familiar non-musical instrument are the horn of vehicles and the bell of bicycle or rickshaw. So, my dear students, I hope all of you have understood our today's topic. Read this chapter properly. See you again in the next class. My dear students, I have given you HW. This is HW number 6 and you have to make 10 MCQ from this chapter. Submit it on Saturday. My dear students, see you again in the next class. Allah Hafiz.